What helps us walk? Understanding bones of the leg. Our lower limb consists of four main bones: femur, patella, tibia, and fibula. Femur is the bone in the thigh, patella, the kneecap, tibia, the shin bone, which is the larger of the two leg bones located below the kneecap, and the fourth, the fibula, is the smaller one. Other bones include the metatarsals and phalanges. The femur is the strongest bone in the body. It is also the longest. The top of the femur connects to a hollowed out part of the hip bone called the acetabulum. The patella, commonly known as the kneecap, interacts with the bottom of the femur. The femur also has knobs that interact with the top of the tibia. The tibia, or the shin bone, is far thicker than its neighbor and is located on the inside or medial portion of the lower leg. Although the fibula is thinner, it is about the same length as the tibia. The lateral malleolus is the outside, bottom end of the fibula. It is the protrusion of the outside of your ankle. Our foot is designed in much the same way as our hands. The ankle, which is similar to the wrist, has seven tarsal bones. The set of bones is called the tarsus. One of those bones is a part of a joint with a great range of motion, the talus. The talus bone joins the tibia and fibula and allows the ankle to rotate. Calcaneus, or the heel bone, is the largest of the tarsus. The instep of our foot is similar to the palm of our hand, but instead of metacarpals, it has metatarsals. The ends of the metatarsals on the bottom of our foot form the ball of our foot. As such, the metatarsals also help the calcaneus and talus to support our body weight. Ligaments and tendons, wrapping the tarsals and metatarsals together, form the arches of our feet. Our toes are also called phalanges, just like our fingers. Moreover, just like our thumbs, our big toes also have only two phalanges. However, the rest of our toes have three: proximal, middle, and distal.